Good day from Chem Help ASAP. While many drugs have low renal clearance, let's still discuss the basics of why renal clearance is highly relevant to drug discovery. On the screen, we have a very rough graphic of how renal clearance works. Disclaimer, this video is not a human anatomy class. So we start with blood flow into the kidneys. Through filtration, a portion of the blood is essentially separated into two fractions. One is the cellular fraction, with cells, proteins, including albumin, and some fluid. The other is mostly fluid, plasma, without the plasma proteins. Small molecule oral drugs are in this latter fraction. This plasma-like fraction travels through the nephrons of the kidney, and the nephron reabsorbs the important components, salts, and much of the water. So at this step, we have reabsorption. Absorbed components are returned to the blood supply, and unabsorbed components, mostly waste from the body, form urine. Are drugs absorbed or not? Oral drugs are designed to cross membranes for good absorption, so most drugs are reabsorbed and not lost. Therefore, the renal extraction ratio for most oral drugs is negligibly small, essentially zero, and therefore, renal clearance is essentially zero. So why are we talking about renal clearance? Renal clearance does affect some drugs. If you research drugs online, you'll find that resources like Wikipedia, Drug Bank, and drug literature will sometimes mention that a drug is excreted by the kidneys in unchanged form. Most antibiotics are at least partially cleared by the kidneys and can be found in unchanged form in a patient's urine. In fact, analysis of an animal's or a patient's urine for unchanged drug is a way to determine renal clearance. If there is unchanged drug, then what is a changed drug? That is normally a reference to metabolized drug or drug metabolites. While oral drugs are not normally cleared, their metabolites very often are. Metabolites often have structures that are not reabsorbed during renal filtration. So analysis of urine may show very small amounts of the unchanged drug, but a large portion of the changed or metabolized drug. Therefore, renal clearance is very important for drug discovery. Administered drugs need a method for leaving the body, and the kidneys are the exit route for most drug metabolites. As a final note, proper kidney function is required for renal clearance. If a patient has impaired kidney function, then renal clearance will be reduced. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.